Imagine if your watch could shock you every time you indulged in a bad habit. Well, now it can. Everyone has bad habits they want to break. Drinking, smoking, shoplifting expensive underwear from department stores. A new product promises a supposedly quick solution, not unlike attaching a car battery clamp to yourself. Pavlok is a $199 device you wear on your wrist that shocks you with between 50 and 450 volts to create negative associations with bad habits. According to the New York Times' Jennifer Jolly, at its worst, Pavlok feels like getting stung by a bee with a stinger the size of an ice pick. Just download the app, choose your bad habit, and get zapping. The company that produces Pavlok says it takes at least 5 days to blast the bad habit out of you. Its creator, an entrepreneur named Manish Sethi, raised Pavlok funding on Indiegogo and from angel investors. He's only now planning clinical trials of the device, despite the fact that 10,000 people have already used it. So by my math, that's $2 million he's made without any regulation or review. Let's be clear, this isn't electroconvulsive therapy like they did to that poor lady in Requiem for a Dream. No, Pavlok purports to be based on the research of Ivan Pavlov. Get it? Pavlov, Pavlok, yeah. Anyway, this kind of training is called classical conditioning and led to psychological theories about how it might work in us humans. But hold up, while some conditioning relies on punishment instead of rewards, Pavlok is more like aversion therapy, where a patient learns to associate discomfort with an undesirable behavior. Kind of like in Clockwork Orange, when Alex is electrocuted and given nauseating drugs so he'll associate his violent urges with sickening feelings. It's been used in real life to treat alcoholism, smoking addiction, and even homosexuality back when it was considered a sexual deviation. Yeah, that doesn't work. But what about drinking or smoking? Would Pavlok work on that? Well, some hospitals have reported success with aversion therapy, and one's even interested in using this new device. But the long-term success of aversion therapy is questionable, and its use in abusing patients is still criticized. So until Pavlok's been further studied, we don't know if it's any better than just snapping a rubber band on your wrist. Doctors recommend other long-term therapeutic options for dealing with your bad habits. So what do you think? Would you buy one? Let us know on social media. And if you want to learn more about the latest in torture, wearable devices, and psychology, make sure to visit us every day at now.howstuffworks.com.